So there are three main elements here. First of all, raising financing under attractive condition remains a big challenge, and especially for companies which do not have a product on the market yet, or which do not have any advanced clinical data sets. And this hurdle is due on one hand to the challenging macroeconomic environment and the rise we have seen in interest rates. And then on the other hand, and this is kind of related to the fact that the sector has been out of favor for the last 2 years or so. Secondly, if we look at our coverage, so mainly Benelux and French companies, we see that 50% of those will need to raise capital to bridge the gap until next year. So there is a clear urgency there. And what we observe is that as a result thereof, the share price of those companies, so for example, Onward Medical or Sequana Medical, have been hit pretty hard in the recent months, despite them often publishing positive news. Lastly, and on a more positive note, if we look at the earlier stage private companies that attended our conference this year, we see that the Benelux healthcare ecosystem is still very active with a lot of exciting innovation going on in this space, and hopefully this will translate into a new treatment for patients down the line.
Definitely, especially towards the end of the year, we've seen a tremendous amount of deal activity. More specifically, we've seen 5 deals of at least $1 billion, and then also one deal in the neurology space of around $14 billion, which is quite significant. And if you compare with 2022, we point out that although the number of deals was slightly down, the overall deal value was up about 40%. We saw a lot of activity in three main sectors, being first of all oncology, but also obesity and neurology. So the first one, oncology, that's a usual suspect. There, the current M&A streak has been fueled mostly by big pharma's interest in antibody drug conjugates and radiopharmaceuticals. These type of modalities offer an enhanced safety profile versus traditional chemotherapy, and in a lot of cases also yield very strong efficacy results.
Secondly, there is neurology. This space is definitely going through a revival, and this is not very surprising because on one hand, there is still a huge unmet need for efficacious treatments in the disease areas of Alzheimer's or schizophrenia. And then on the other hand, we have seen the strong Alzheimer data published by Eli Lilly last year. Finally, there is obesity. That space also gained quite some traction following the compelling weight loss data from the so-called GLP-1 drugs from Eli Lilly or Novo Nordisk. And recently, Roche also entered that space with the acquisition of Carmot. And we expect that M&A activity to continue in the sector, also with the entrance of new medicine with new mechanism of action. Yes, we do not expect the M&A activity to slow down over 2024 because big pharmas are still facing steep patent cliffs with around $200 billion of revenue at risk through 2030. Secondly, we see regulatory changes, for example, the IRA, which forces big pharmas to rebuild their pipeline and hence to fall back on biotechs. And then also keep in mind that the valuation of biotechs, even those with late stage assets, are still relatively low following 2 years of depressed sentiment, and hence there are attractive deals to be made there.
I think there's plenty of elements out there that make us believe that we will at least see a partial recovery of the sector in 2024, although in general we remain cautious, especially in Europe. Interest rates seem to have stabilized, but we haven't seen the Fed cut rates yet, but we do hold up our conviction that this will happen at some point in the year. This is of course an event that will have a positive impact on the sector sentiment, as future cash flows will have to be discounted at lower rates, which has a positive impact on biotech company valuations. A second element is of course M&A, as we previously highlighted. I think that continued M&A will keep on highlighting the innovative role that biotech companies play in the overall healthcare ecosystem. Of course, it remains to be seen, however, how antitrust regulators will assess each one of these deals, as they previously opposed the Amgen Horizon Therapeutics takeover. In terms of IPOs, I think we're off to a great start. We recently saw bladder cancer company CG Oncology IPO in the United States. They raised more than $300 million, which is quite impressive. And we see other names lining up to go public as well. These are all companies which are a little bit more mature with advanced clinical data sets, and we expect these to be the type of companies that will IPO at least in the near to midterm, while investors are still regaining their trust and confidence in the sector.